everyone. This is Dr. K. Jagannaiki, Professor in MBA Department, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. Today, I would like to discuss with you about Introduction to Financial Accounting. See, financial accounting is very useful for any type of business organization to know their financial performance. So, after going through this topic, the learner will be able to understand the meaning of financial accounting, objectives, importance, features of financial accounting, who are the major users of financial accounting, and what are the different functions of financial accounting. So, let us start with introduction. Financial accounting is a specific branch of accounting involving a process of recording, summarizing, and reporting the myriad of transactions resulting from business operations over a period of time. So, these transactions are summarized in the preparation of the final statements, which includes the balance sheet, income statement, cash flow statement, funds flow statement, and so on, that record a company's operating performance over a specified period. So, in general, every business organization, they used to maintain different types of accounting books. The day-to-day transactions they used to mention in a book which is known as journal. The same they further categorized in detail which account, whether it is cash account or capital, sales account, purchase account, like that they used to record in another book which is known as ledger. Based on that, at the end of the financial year, every company they used to publish the complete information about their financials, like profitability and overall financial health of the company with the help of different types of final accounts. Work opportunities for a financial accountant can be found in both public and private sectors. A financial accountant's duties may differ from those of a general accountant who works for themselves rather than directly for a company or an organization. So, whoever they are going to record this type of accounting information, for example, if you see, there is a lot of difference in sole proprietorship, partnership, joint stock company in way of maintaining the account books. Financial accounting is the framework that dictates the rules, processes, and standards for financial record keeping. Nonprofits, corporations, and small businesses use financial accounts to prepare their books and records and generate their financial reports. So, these reports are useful to stakeholders like investors, government, management, and other people. They used to get financial information about a particular company on these statements. So, financial reporting occurs through the use of financial statements such as the balance sheet, income statement, statement of cash flow, and statement of changes in shareholders' equity. Every type of information we should get directly from the financial accounts. Financial accounting, it differs from managerial accounting. As financial reporting is for reporting to external parties, whereas managerial accounting is for internal strategic planning. Financial accounting may be performed under accrual method, which means that recording expenses for items that have not yet been paid, or the cash method, only cash transactions are recorded. Then coming to the objectives of financial accounting, according to principles of financial accounting, the main objective is to provide all internal and external stakeholders with an accurate view of profits and losses. So, as we know, the ultimate objective of any business entity is profit maximization and cost minimization, so that the companies can analyze the overall performance in terms of their financials. So for that reason, people can have understanding of financial accounting. This in-depth financial analysis, it allows organizations to protect stakeholders' interest, meet legal requirements, and optimize resource allocation. The few other objectives of financial accounting are compliance with statutory requirement. Even whenever they want to come out with strategic decisions, they can able to analyze or they can able to make effective decisions based on their financial stability. Then record keeping is another important objective of accounting. Determine profitability. Profitability we can able to assess with the help of financial accounting data and managerial decision making. So the top level management every day they have to make number of decisions related to their future. If the decisions are strategic, if they want to attain their long-term goals, then for that they need sufficient funds available within the organization. Then only they can able to achieve their long-term goals. Then coming with the first one, compliance with statutory requirements. So through the process of financial accounting, organizations comply with tax regulations, the Companies Act 1956, and other statutory requirements of the country in which the company conducts their business successfully. And next one is record keeping. It creates a systematic process for recording financial transactions in the books of account. Organizations use these transactions to analyze and optimize their financial performance. And third one is determine profitability. So generally, the final accounts are also helpful to understand the profitability position of a company. So that can be measured with the help of the net income of a company, which can be derived by using the total assets, liabilities, and equities. While a simple way to calculate profit and loss is to subtract spending from revenues, simply we can find out whether a company is running with profits or losses. So profitability also considers the other factors such as pricing of goods and services, purchases, rent, salary, general expenses, depreciation, interest rate, and taxes, and so on. Then fourth one is management decision making. A robust accounting process enables stakeholders, shareholders, creditors, investors, and other parties to gauge an organization's financial stability. It aids in management team in making analytical decisions for maximizing their sales and profits. Coming to the importance of financial accounting, it is important to track the financial transactions and prepare final statements. Consistent standards. Financial accounts make it easy for organizations to create financial statements that follow universally accepted standards. So wherever go, they used to maintain the same standards throughout the world. Improved accountability. So financial statements improve an organization's credibility among regulatory bodies, tax authorities, and lenders. And efficient decision making is another important factor of financial accounting. So financial performance analysis, it enables enterprises to invest and allocate resources better, and transparency should be maintained in terms of reporting the data in financial statements. So financial accounting also promotes transparency by setting the rules that organization must follow while disclosing their financial performance. And next, a reliable source of information. The rules set by independent governing bodies ensure accurate reporting practices among organizations. Then coming to the features of financial accounting, some of the important characteristic features of financial accounting are monetary recording keeper. Only financial accounts record monetary transactions regardless of their importance from a business point of view. For example, A invested 1 lakh in the business. So this type of transactions they used to enter into the books of journals. So this is how we used to write capital account data to cash account. So it means that Mr. A invested 1 lakh rupees as cash in the business in the form of capital. So only that kind of monetary transactions they used to enter in the final accounts. And second, historical transaction recording. So financial accounts only track transactions that have already taken place in the past. And legal requirement, as law mandates, organizations must keep their financial accounts up to date. They should also get financial statement audited to ensure accuracy and made for external use. So whatever records they used to maintain and that financial accounting reports, they are useful to customers, investors, suppliers and financial institutions about the financial performance of an organization. The next one is interim reports. So organizations treat financial account statements covering less than a year as interim reports. These reports are useful for conveying the financial performance before a full year reporting cycle ends. So sometimes within to make use of this kind of financial information within the company, they used to produce interim reports. For external users, after completion of the financial year ending only, they are supposed to disclose their financial status of a company. Then forms the basis of other accounting branches. So financial accounting deals with the raw data from journals and ledgers. Therefore, it is the foundation or basis for other accounting branches such as management accounting, cost accounting and other advanced accounting methods. Then what are the main functions of financial accounting? The significant advantages of financial accounting are to create financial statements that helps investors, tax authorities, lenders to understand the organization's financial position. So accountants create these reports like income statement, cash flow statement, balance sheet, profit and loss account by tracking incoming and outgoing cash flow transactions. So with the help of these financial statements, we can able to analyze or assess the sources of revenue and what amount you are spending for other purposes. So that we can able to analyze with the help of financial statements. Then some of the functions of financial accounting are maintain systematic records. So financial accounting records financial transactions accurately while meeting accounting standards and regulatory guidelines. Then analyze and summarize financial records. Accounting team creates final accounts after analyzing and summarizing transactions in the trial balance. So after posting financial transactions in both the books of journal and ledger, they used to create one more statement which is known as trial balance. So in this they are able to assess the assets and liabilities of the company. So the final statement shows the profits or losses of an organization during a financial year. So with the help of preparing this kind of trial balance, become able to know the company's position, whether the number of assets available with the company and how many assets you have already been used. Then communicate results. So financial accounts help organizations share their annual historical or financial actual performance with the investors, shareholders, government bodies, lenders and debtors, and meet legal requirements. So while preparing the financial statements, as we already know, some standards we are going to maintain throughout the world, we should follow the same rules, and based on that we have to prepare our accounting statements. So financial accounting ensures organizations fulfill their legal obligations such as book auditing and tax liabilities. So whatever you are showing in the books, even the liabilities of tax related aspects also should match with each other. So for that purpose, the auditors will work on that. Then how financial accounting works. Financial accounting utilizes a series of established principles. The accounting principles used depend on business, regulatory and reporting requirements. So companies and organizations often use an accounting manual that gives complete details about the accounting rules of that particular company. Generally, US public companies are required to perform financial accounting in accordance with generally accepted accounting principles. So, which are known as GAAP, generally accepted accounting principles. So, their purpose is to provide consistent information to investors, creditors, regulators, and tax authorities. Only that accurate information they use to provide to the external users. The statements used in financial accounting cover the five main classifications of financial data, which are revenues. Revenues include the income from sales of products and services, plus other sources including dividends and interest. So they are the sources of generating the revenue. And expenses, these are the cost of producing goods and services, from research and development to marketing to payroll. So entire things comes under expenses. The next one is assets. Consist of owned property, both tangible and intangible. So tangible assets means buildings, land, computers, machinery, all those things comes under tangible assets. Whereas coming to intangible assets, patent, trademarks, goodwill, etc. The next, liabilities. So these are all outstanding debts such as loans or rent. That comes under liabilities. Then equity. If you paid off the company's debts and liquidated its assets, you would get its equity. So which is what a company is worth. So company share capital is also known as equity capital. Then users of financial accounting. Public enterprises publish financial statements quarterly or annually to provide internal and external users with critical financial information. So lenders compare assets and liabilities to predict an organization's ability to repay loans. So lenders means like financial institutions, banks, they used to analyze the credit worthiness of a company. So based on that, they used to provide loans. So for that reason, they have to use the company's financials. Then whereas coming to investors, they analyze financial statements to estimate investment risk and predict future returns or dividends. Suppliers and trade creditors need financial information to measure the short-term liquidity of an organization. And customers use these statements to understand the long run prospects of a business. So these are some of the uses of financial accounting. And employees and trade unions will also have a look on financial data so that they can easily interpret organization profitability and stability. So if the organization running with profits and they are stabilized, then there is no problem to the employees. And company management leverages accounting information to evaluate progress and pinpoint areas of improvement. So management look into financial accounting statements to understand the prospects of the company, and also they used to find out the areas where they need to focus. And government agencies include income tax and sales tax departments need financial information to levy and collect appropriate taxes from the business organizations. And investment analysts, they use financial statements to analyze an organization's competitive performance. Then coming to the types of financial accounting, basically it is divided into two types, cash accounting and accrual accounting. The basic difference between these two is the timing of transaction recording. So the first one is cash accounting. It is a method of accounting where transactions are recorded when cash is received or paid out. So immediately they used to record in the book of cash. Whereas coming to accrual accounting, it is a method of accounting where transactions are recorded when they are earned or incurred, regardless of when the cash is received or paid out. So nothing related to cash transactions, but only in case of cash method, only cash related transactions we are going to record in the books of accounts. Whereas accrual record accounting, once the transaction took place, immediately they will mention that without cash transactions. So coming to the first one, accrual method, it records transactions as they occur regardless of when the money exchange happens. So today we are buying something on credit basis. So immediately the transaction related information they used to record under accrual method. How the customer made purchases on credit basis. But when he is going to pay, repay the amount, that kind of thing, immaterial to accrual method. Organizations use accrual basis accounting to create journal entries for sales and expenses even before collecting or making payments. So accrual based accounting follows the revenue matching principle, which requires revenue and expense recording in the same period of time. It uses double entry accounting to record liabilities for debit incurred but cash not paid, and assets for income earned but money not received, but still we are going to maintain the record of that particular transaction. The accrual method is standard among enterprises handling large volumes of credit transactions. So they used to maintain accrual method to maintain their financial transactions. Let us take one example of accrual method. So an example of accrual method or accounting is how an organization records revenue using accrual accounting. Imagine XYZ Private Limited delivered goods and services worth rupees 50,000 to ABC Private Limited on 15th February. Now, XYZ Private Limited records revenue as they make a sale, meaning they add revenue to their books before receiving cash. ABC Private Limited receives an invoice they must pay within 20 days. So here they used to enter in cash journal entry in the month of February and March. So they will specify February month accounts receivable, ABC Private Limited. So debited how much? 50,000. And revenue generated, that is going to credit after making payment after 20 days. So that is to be credited. Same amount, 50,000. Whereas in the month of March, anyhow they used to get cash. So debit side, you have to specify cash of rupees 50 even on credit side. The cash journal entries for this transaction require XYZ Private Limited to capture service revenue in February and record payment in March. So that is the difference between cash method and accrual method. Then coming to the second one, cash method. The cash accounting method records transactions when the money exchange happens. Whenever a cash transaction took place, then that should be immediately recorded in cash book. For example, an organization records income after receiving cash from sales and expenses after processing accounts payable. Cash basis accounting requires transaction recording only when money goes in or out of a bank statement. And this method suits small business organizations. Enterprises with large inventories don't use cash accounting as it does not capture liabilities incurred but not paid yet. So that is the reason cash method only small business organizations they will use. Coming to the example of cash accounting. If you see the example, how enterprise record revenue and spending using the cash-based method, imagine Curtis Private Limited sells curtains worth 30,000 rupees to Aris Private Limited on 10th April. The cash journal entries below show how Curtis Private Limited records the revenue only after they receive payment from Aris Private Limited on April 11th. So here they have mentioned the transactions details and revenue once if they receive from other company, then only they used to enter in the cash journal entry. Then the basic differences between accrual method and cash method. Accrual method records transactions when benefit is received or liability is incurred. But whereas cash method records transactions when cash is received or distributed. Then under accrual method, it is a more accurate method of accounting that depicts more realistic business operations. Whereas an easier method of accounting that simplifies a company down to what has already actually occurred, that we are going to mention in the cash method. The third one under accrual method required for larger public companies as part of external reporting, and whereas cash method primarily used by smaller private companies with a low to no reporting requirements. Then coming to the financial statements, there are four main financial statements. One is balance sheet, second one income statement, third cash flow statement, and fourth statement of retained earnings, which is also known as statement of owner's equity. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.